इफ वी हैव सेवन सेंटर बैक्स अवेलेबल निधि एट द मोमेंट सेवन भाई, लेट्स प्ले फोर सेंटर बैक्स इन द गेम फाइव।
इट्स लाइक तू इकोनॉमी में जा रहा था, अचानक तेरे को बिजनेस का अपग्रेड मिल गया ना, यू बी लाइक Welcome to Minutes in the Mock, yet another video, and we are joined by two very special guests. Manas, of course, is there, like always, but we also have our in-house expert, Ritwik. He's there, and we have a new person on the video. Please welcome Prathamesh, as he's better known on Twitter, Tactically Obsessed. So, you know, and we are going to talk about the center back issue. We are going to talk about, you know, things that have happened that we can look forward to, things we can expect, those kind of things. So let's get it started. Prathamesh, what are your thoughts on the injuries that happened last season? What, I mean, now that, you know, we can talk about, say that in past tense, finally.
Finally, dude. Yeah.
वन वर्ड डिस्क्रिप्शन वॉज अनफॉर्चुनेट, मतलब कोई सेंस ही नहीं बनता था ना, एक के बाद एक इंजरी, मतलब वो पोजीशन ही कर्स हो गया था। वैन डाइक खेला, इंजर्ड हो गया, गोमेज वो पोजीशन पे खेला, इंजर्ड हो गया, फिर मैटिप खेला, मैटिप ऑन एंड ऑफ इंजर 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 एंड देन फाइनली ही गॉट इंजर्ड फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम। हेंडरसन खेला, हेंडरसन इंजर्ड हो गया, मतलब कौन एक्सपेक्ट कर रहा है कि हेंडरसन वहां पे खेल के इंजर्ड होगा। सो ओवरऑल अगर मैं उसको एक वर्ड में सम अप करूं तो it was out and out unfortunate, and yeah. As a Klopp was almost helpless because the point that these injuries were happening was right in the middle of the season, matlab october mein ho raha hai, he has no, he matlab uske paas koi time hi nahi bacha na koi plan b khada karne ka, wo ho gaya. Uske baad gomez ka bhi I guess almost do teen hafton ke baad hua tha, एंड ऑन टॉप ऑफ इट जो फिक्स्चर क्रंच था उसमें तो मतलब देयर वाज नो ब्रीदिंग स्पेस, एंड द फैक्ट कि हम लोग कितना 20 सेंटर बैक कॉम्बिनेशंस ट्राई किया हम लोगों ने, विच इज यार नॉट अ स्मॉल नंबर, मतलब 20 कौन करता है यार, एक के बाद मतलब अगर कहीं पर बेटिंग चल रहा है ना तो वो सही टाइम था कि मतलब आज कौन सेंटर बैक पेयरिंग खेलेगा, इतना मतलब इतना परम्यूटेशन ऑफ कॉम्बिनेशन
जो गोमेज माइट बी बैक अर्लियर देन व्हाट वी एक्सपेक्टेड, जेम्स पियर्स हैड यू नो हैड अ कन्वर्सेशन वेर ही कन्फर्म्ड दिस, सो यू नो व्हाट आर योर थॉट्स ऑन द रिटर्न ऑफ द सेंटर बैक्स?
So this entire video that we're doing is based on the center back situation, which was and which is and which will be. I thought that Joe Gomez is going to be out for a long time, which means probably I was thinking till the end of this year. This year, I think he would have been. Meko to aise lag raha tha, but that tweet that you mentioned has obviously raised everyone's spirit. So Gomez is going to be back. Van Dijk, I think, is there. Preseason will be very important for him and Matip as well. I think Matip is fit. And Gomez is on a quicker recovery. So I think it's brilliant with Konate coming in as well. But mere hisab se, Ritwik, if everyone was fit last season, I prefer Matip and Van Dijk. Like, this is my go-to pairing. Not that I have anything against Joe Gomez. Joe Gomez, still very young. But I'm more happier that Matip is also fit, Van Dijk is also fit. Because that is my go-to pairing. Ritwik, what do you think?
Yeah, that's actually a very fair shout. Because as good as Van Dijk is, Matip also raises the level of the team. I mean, he's really, really good with the ball at his feet. He can carry the ball. You see we funnily joke about how he carries the ball like Messi in a kind of a weird fashion. He's really good on the ball. He's really good in the air. His aerial success rate is almost similar to Van Dijk. he's one of the best aerial duel winner in the league as well, which Gomez isn't. So, and one of the most important things about Matip is he reads the game better than Joe Gomez does. So, I mean, he's more of a proactive defender than a reactive one. Although he doesn't have a huge recovery pace, he still uses his long legs to cover distances quite quickly. So he's very intelligent. I think he's a perfect partner for Van Dijk as well, like you mentioned. Again, yeah that's actually a very fair shout.
Nidhi, do you think Matip and Van Dijk are our best centre-back pairing?
Yes, I do agree with that. Look, I mean, the technical aspects of it, you guys have already mentioned that, you know, he's better in the air and, you know, he reads the situations much better. I think that Matip is also better at organizing people around him. There have been a lot of games where, you know, Van Dijk has been, you know, busy with, you know, defending against a particular striker or in a situation, and he's the one getting Trent and Robbo in their positions, talking to Fabinho to get into position, those kind of things. I think that he's also much better at, you know, not in terms of a pure creating chance kind of a situation, but he's also better at linking the midfield and then the attacking third.
Yeah.
So definitely, yeah. I would say that, you know, that is the best centre-back pairing that we have.
Prathamesh, for you?
Yeah, absolutely. Because I guess Klopp will also prefer that centre-back pairing, because if you remember, apna jo Champions League final tha versus Spurs, the centre-back pairing was Matip and Van Dijk. So, it gives a perfect balance for Klopp ke high line khel rahe hai, but phir bhi ek kafi zyada composed centre-back pairing hai. Because Gomez kind of thoda sa nervy ho jata hai at times when the counter-attack triggers from the opposite end. But with these two, I guess they are very much calm, composed, and as Ritwik mentioned, Matip ka game reading sense bahut acha hai. Like, he knows when to go in for the tackle and when not to. And he's someone who can soak that pressure.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, even if like in case agar apna corner hai and Van Dijk is already into the opposite box, तो मैटिप इज समवन जिसको पता है कि कब ट्रिगर करना है, कब इंटरसेप्ट करना है बॉल को. तो उसका जो अंडरस्टैंडिंग है, इवन विद फेबिनियो, एज निधि मेंशन, कि जो लिंकअप है उसका मिडफील्ड के साथ, वो भी काफी ज्यादा पोटेंट है अपने एंड से काउंटर अटैक ट्रिगर करने में. सो आई गेस यस, दैट कुड बी द राइट सेंटर बैक पेयरिंग फॉर द कमिंग सीजन.
It'll be really interesting because we have now Matip, Gomez, Van Dijk back, and Ritwik, we've signed Konate. Okay. We decided not to sign Ozan Kabak on a permanent deal, and we signed Konate. Ozan Kabak was raising his level game by game, young player, but we've gone for another promising young player. Ritwik, can you just tell us why Konate and not Kabak? Considering the fact that Konate is expensive as well, and our owners are not known to take the expensive option.
I think we've decided to pay the 34 million release clause for Konate. I guess it was 34 million, right? Yeah. And I mean, people actually rave a lot about how good Upamecano was for Leipzig. But in terms of potential alone, Konate has a higher ceiling than Upamecano. And I think you can ask a lot of people who follow the Bundesliga and they say the same thing. He's really good in possession. He can spray really good long passes. And unlike a lot of other center backs who normally decide to like push the ball towards the full backs, he just manages to vertically pass through to the midfield as well as the attack. He's a really good ball carrier as well. And in defense, he is taller than Gomez. He is like 193 centimeters tall. So he's really
taller
good in
the
air.
He's
taller than Gomez. Yeah. So he's really good in the air. And he has good pace as well. And he's really, really strong. So he doesn't get easily brushed off in challenges. I've seen him like compete against big people like Weghorst, etc. And like he's handled those really well. So, I mean, he's strong and he's much better than Kabak overall. I mean, Kabak, although he played quite well for us towards the end of the season, I don't think Konate's ability on the ball is like comparable with Kabak at all. I mean, Kabak is nowhere near Konate in terms of how good they are on the ball.
But Prathamesh, I mean, these are really good insights given by Ritwik. But one thing which Twitter is, it's negative. It's toxic. And the moment we signed him, people started talking about his injury record. मतलब एक गेम खेला भी नहीं और उसके इंजरी रिकॉर्ड के बारे में बात कर रहे थे. Now, are you a bit, as a normal layman, as a supporter, are you a bit scared, skeptical that ki we've signed a player with another injury record, past of plenty of injuries?
No. Actually, to be very honest, because of the number of injuries that we had last season, fans ना काफी ज़्यादा paranoid हो गए. They are very scared. मतलब एक प्लेयर इंजर्ड हुआ नहीं कि उसका रिप्लेसमेंट ढूंढो. आई मीन हाँ, ये सब मतलब नॉर्मल मोबाइल कंप्यूटर वाले गेम में बहुत फैंसी लगता है, बट इन रियल फुटबॉल इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. यू कैनॉट हैव अ रिप्लेसमेंट फॉर एवरी इंजर्ड प्लेयर. एंड कोनाटे के जितने भी इंजरीज हुए, द मेन प्रॉब्लम वॉज लाइप्ज़िग वॉज रशिंग फॉर हिज रिकवरी. मतलब इवन विद हिज 80% ऑफ फिटनेस, ही वॉज बींग पुश्ड टू प्ले. वो ऑब्वियसली एनी प्लेयर के लिए वो काफी ज्यादा रिस्की फैक्टर हो सकता है, लाइक स्पेशली अ सेंटर बैक जहां पे ही हैज टू पुट इन टैकल्स, ही हैज टू डाइव इन टू विन द बॉल्स, ही हैज टू जंप रेगुलरली टू विन द एरियल ड्यूल्स. वो काफी ज्यादा रिस्की हो सकता है किसी भी सेंटर बैक के लिए. एंड वही चीज हो रही थी एट लिवरपूल. क्लॉप टचवुड वोंट हैव दैट प्रॉब्लम, बिकॉज व्हेन यू हैव 5 or 6 सेंटर बैक्स एट योर डिस्पोजल, किसी भी इंजर्ड सेंटर बैक को खींचने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी. लाइक जो लास्ट टाइम अपना प्रॉब्लम हो रहा था विद मैटिप, नॉट एग्जैक्टली लास्ट सीजन बट उसके पहले वाले सीजन तक जो प्रॉब्लम थी कि ओके गोमेज इंजर्ड है तो मैटिप को लाओ, मैटिप कितना 90% फिट है, ठीक है खिला लेते हैं उसको, तब तक अपना गोमेज फिट हो जाएगा, हम लोग गोमेज को वापस ला लेंगे. बट इस बार वो प्रॉब्लम नहीं हो सकती बिकॉज ऑफ द एबंडेंस ऑफ सेंटर बैक्स दैट वी हैव. एंड सेकेंडली कोनाटे के जितने भी इंजरीज रहे हैं, वो आई फील के वो पूरी तरह से उसको ट्रीट भी नहीं किया था. आई फील बिकॉज इफ वी सी, वो जब भी आ रहा था लाइप्ज़िग के लाइनअप में खेल रहा था, ही वॉजेंट 100% कंफर्टेबल. वो एक दिखाई दे रहा था, इट वॉज क्वाइट एविडेंट बिकॉज उसके मूवमेंट्स भी काफी ज्यादा रेस्ट्रिक्टेड लग रहे थे. तो स्पेशली अगेंस्ट जो लिवरपूल वाला मैच भी था, इट आई एम वेरी श्योर के इफ उसका अगर इंजरी फ्री सीजन होता, ही वुड हैव बीन मच मोर इंपैक्टफुल इन दैट गेम.
निधि,
यस,
वेयर डज दिस लीव नैट फिलिप्स?
लुक, इफ यू आस्क अबाउट द पैकिंग ऑर्डर, आई थिंक राइट नाउ इट्स वैन डाइक हु इज एब्सोल्युटली अशर्ड ऑफ अ पोजीशन, देन इट कम्स मैटिप एंड गोमेज. And actually, that is connected to the next question, and I'll ask that question in a bit. And then Konate, and then Nat Phillips. I personally think that Nat Phillips would want to move on. There have been reports about Newcastle, Burnley. Look, he's 24, 25. He will want to play regularly. And let's be fair. It's not going to be he's not going to be a regular unless there are those many injuries. Because Manas, if you remember, even with Nat Phillips being available, Klopp took a long time for him to play.
He played Hendo and Fabinho as center backs even when Nat was available.
So and as we've said in another videos, there are some natural limitations to Nat Phillips game. But Manas and Ritwik, I wanted to ask you guys this. Ritwik, you I want to ask you. Now, this Konate is 21 or 22 years old. He's very young. Do you even see him, playing games straight away? Knowing how Klopp is, he allows players to settle in, and then, even Robbo, Ox, everybody. He allows players to settle in. Do you think Konate will play straight away?
That's actually a very tricky question, because when we signed Robertson and Fabinho, both were in like pretty stocky, they were like pretty slim and they used to get brushed away pretty easily. Fabinho even now gets like brushed away pretty easily when he comes up against physical players. But I think one factor that Konate has to himself is that he is very strong. So I think in terms of physicality, I don't think there's going to be a second thought from Klopp's side. So, and quality wise as well, I don't think he's played at Leipzig, who are a team with their backline very much exposed. So he is pretty much used to last ditch tackles, tracking back players, and you know, using that extra bit of pace to catch up players as well. So stylistically as well, I think he's pretty much fit for Liverpool. So I think he's going to be incorporated faster than what we saw with Robbo, Ox or Fabinho.
But Prathamesh, like he mentioned about Leipzig, okay, the defense is exposed. Now we can potentially have 4, 5, even 6 centre-backs at our disposal. Can we actually think about playing 3 at the back? Like at Leipzig, he played in a 3 at the back, if I'm not wrong. And they have 2 wing-backs, which is bomb forward. If we have Van Dijk, Matip, Gomez, Konate, one of either Ben Davis as a backup, Reece Williams and Phillips. So, 6 centre-back ho sakte, 5-6. Can we actually play 3 at the back? Is it something Klopp will do?
I personally don't think so. Because agar hum log 3 at the back khel rahe, toh it's like almost 50% of our entire centre-back entourage would be into it. And aise case mein jahan pe Matic ka fitness record, I mean agar apne paas 5 or 6 center backs hai to usme jo almost 3 to hum log ek match mein khila rahe ikatthe and usme knowing ke apna Gomez ka fitness kaisa raha hai in the past few seasons, same goes with Matic, to that could be potentially thoda sa risky teenon ko ek sath khilana. I guess instead of playing 3 at the back, there will be heavy rotation center back ke slots mein. That is what I feel.
Heavy rotation, Nidhi, dekho kya lagta? I don't think Van Dijk will be someone like Van Dijk might be the one who is playing majority of the games. But but the more I think about it, I think Prathamesh is correct because these three are coming back from a long term injury, Nidhi.
The word that you use for players like Virgil van Dijk is rest, not rotate. We'll probably have to rest Virgil van Dijk and of course sort of rehabilitate back him into the team. Now, here's my point with 3 at the back. Since Klopp has come in, we've always played 4 at the back, right? With, you know, Fabinho, with Hendo. Playing 3 at the back requires for a complete change in approach, right? You have to understand that the team is used to playing in a certain way. That's a very big shift. We are not talking about, you know, making a couple of changes up top while the, you know, the build-up from the back remains the same, which has been the case with me. I personally don't think we'll be playing 3 at the back, also because of the reasons that Prathamesh mentioned. But I think that's too vast a change compared to his style. Perhaps in some games, perhaps in some cup games, we can see some experimentation, but not full on. I don't think so.
No, I personally also feel, Ritwik, sorry. I also personally feel that we won't make that change because it's too big a change. But I'm just thinking now, you know, at times, Ritwik, we think about plan B. Kya hai? You know, we think about at times ki there's nothing happening. If you remember, we had a 6-game losing streak at Anfield. You were thinking, kuch to alag karo. You know, just change something.
Nothing like that.
No. I mean, one main reason is Klopp normally hates playing 3 at the back. I mean, you probably can dig up some of his comments from the past about teams that play with 3 at the back. He's not a fan of playing 3 at the back system. And I think his recent comments on Jogi Löw playing 3 at the back was also not really great. I mean, he would personally go with 4 at the back for Germany if he was German manager right now. So he's not. And when last season was the perfect time to probably try to go with 3 at the back when we had like our main see Klopp playing 3 at the back at all. I don't think he's played that at Dortmund as well. Even when he was back in Germany, he was not a fan. Klopp and Thomas Tuchel, both of them are pretty much inspired from Ralf Rangnick. Probably follow the same path as well. But both very different in their approaches. Tuchel is
no, but bro, I mean, Thomas Tuchel played three at the back and he won the championship.
That's what. That's what. Yeah. They're very, very much different. Although they come from the same place and both have like had comments that kind of indicate for the same.
Fair, fair. Prathamesh, I mean, just to summarize things up, I mean, what do you think is going to be our pairing? I mean, centre-back pairing, if you have to think about whatever we've spoken now, Matip is going to be back, Gomez is going to be back, Van Dijk is going to be back, Konate is going to be there. It's a tough one. We have to pick two. Imagine if you're playing the Champions League final and you have to pick two out of these four.
Before Prathamesh answers that, kitna acha lagta hai na sunke, Van Dijk will be available, Gomez will be available, Matip will be available. There is a new centre-back.
Yeah.
And actually, pure conversation mein, we somehow ignored Ben Davies. In all these equations, the permutation combination of the centre-backs, because Ben Davies has one big added advantage in his favour, which is he's very much used to playing the left side of centre-back pairing, which as compared to Konate, Matip, Gomez, these three defenders don't have that much experience in playing that position. So, yeah,
but Prathamesh, I think Ben Davies could be apne aapko nahi dalega ye conversation mein, thinking agar if these four are there. I don't think Ben Davies will be up at the pecking order. You really think Ben Davies can be a regular starter for Liverpool?
See, he is not going to be a regular starter, but he is going to be a very influential, he's going to play a very influential part in that. Because उसका एडवांटेज ये है कि वो प्रेस्टन में वो पोजीशन पे उतना खेला हुआ है एंड एज अ मैटर ऑफ फैक्ट ही वाज अ कैप्टन ऑफ प्रेस्टन तो उसके पास वो जो क्या बोलते हैं जो नेचुरल लीडरशिप क्वालिटी जो क्लॉप हमेशा देखता है डिफेंडर्स में वो उसके पास ऑलरेडी है एंड लास्ट सीजन व्हेन ही केम ही जॉइंड लिवरपूल ही गॉट इंजर्ड स्ट्रेट अवे वो प्रॉब्लम्स हुई उसके साथ बट आई गेस व्हेन ही इज फिट ही विल डेफिनेटली बी इनटू द कंसीडरेशन ऑफ क्लॉप्स प्लान्स उसको रूल आउट करना इतना आसान नहीं है ऑब्वियसली गोमेज मैटिप और कोनाटे का रेपुटेशन बहुत ज्यादा है बेन डेविस के हिसाब से बट व्हेन इट कम्स टू प्लेइंग इन कप गेम्स आई गेस बेन डेविस रहेगा कंसीडरेशन में एंड इफ ही परफॉर्म्स वेल ओवर देयर देन आई गेस क्लॉप का जो प्रॉब्लम ऑफ प्लेंटी है वो और बढ़ेगा
ऋत्विक क्या लगता है like... This is a very, we've spoken about Nat Phillips. See, Nat Phillips came out of the blue. Let's be honest. He came out of the blue and boom, you know, he made an impression. So it's tough to rule out what Prathamesh is saying. Can we see something similar? Let's hope we don't, because if we do, that means our injuries win. But can we have a breakthrough season for someone like a Ben Davies or even Reece Williams? Yeah, like last 3-4 games, he bloody got us to the top four. Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, Ben Davis's future, I think, pretty much relies on how he does in preseason. It's very hard for a defender to directly come in. And again, talking about Ben Davis, he's also like pretty slim. I mean, he's coming from the championship. He's pretty slim. But one important thing which is in his favor is that he's a left footer playing as a left center back. So if you have a left footed center back playing as in the left center back role, you open up more angles of passing. You open more window for passing than having a right footer there. So that is an added advantage in his favor. And he's like really, really good with this passing. He was actually good in the championship on the ball. He has a good range of passing as well. So that is one thing he's really good at. Again, I think it all comes down to how well he does in preseason. I think one of the most important things is to win or win over Klopp, basically.
Yeah. Nidhi, abhi, it just feels we have so many options, right? At centre-back, meko itna achha lag raha hai, say, like, Ben Davies is a sixth choice, Reece could be a seventh, you know? Like, if we have seven centre-backs available, Nidhi, at the moment. At the moment, seven. Why, let's play four centre-backs in the game. Fuck it.
It's like, to economy mein cha raha tha, achanak tere ko business ka upgrade mil gaya, no? You'll be like... मेरे को एंजॉय करने दो अभी फिलहाल लेट मी जस्ट बिलीव दिस
फोर एट द बैक इज फॉर श्योर बॉयज फोर एट द बैक इज फॉर श्योर
100%.
Yeah, sure, 100%.
I don't think Klopp will go for. I don't think Klopp will.
Van Dijk. If one is fit, who is going to partner Van Dijk to end this video, Nidhi, for you? Van Dijk and who will?
Matip.
Pratamish?
Konate.
Konate. Ritwik?
Konate.
What about you, Manas?
I have never seen Konate play too often. Yeah. If Matip is fit, I will go for Matip. Van Dijk and Matip. But if the boys, if tactically obsessed and Ritwik are saying Konate, Nidhi, so I think Konate, their opinion matters way more because they watch the game in a different way than we do.
Yeah.
So it'll be fun.
या उसका एक रीजन ये भी है ना कि अगर क्लॉप रिलीज क्लॉज डाल के अगर किसी प्लेयर को ले रहे हैं तो वो ऑब्वियसली एज अ बैकअप ऑप्शन तो नहीं होगा.
दैट्स ट्रू, दैट्स एक्चुअली ट्रू. बट आई मीन आई विश वी हैड मोर टाइम, वी आर रनिंग आउट ऑफ टाइम. ऋत्विक, जस्ट टू एंड दिस, इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट मैटिप एंड कोनाटे बीइंग वैन डाइक्स पार्टनर इन क्राइम, वेयर डज दिस लीव जो गोमेज, इफ यू कैन डिस्क्राइब दिस इन अ मिनट.
Again, Joe Gomez could be a right back backup for Trent Alexander-Arnold. Mm-hmm. So he's not just a center back backup. And we need to actually rotate Trent as well. Not rotate, I mean rest, basically, at times. He's played way too many minutes in the last two seasons and we've seen fatigue as well on his side. So he can possibly act as a right back backup since we are hearing rumors of Nico Williams possibly looking for more minutes away. So yeah, I think Gomez might be more involved as a right back as well.
Nidhi, final words from you. You want to say anything?
Just happy that, you know, I just hope that there are no more seasons like this year. I mean, this was a nightmare in terms of center backs. I'm just happy Van Dijk will be back. That is, you know, so good.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, Pratamish, Ritwik, thank you so much. Nidhi, thank you so much. We are building up to a great, great season coming up. And hopefully, we have more conversations like this when it comes to the midfield and forwards as well. Because let's hope we make a signing or two more in those departments. Because Genie has left. We need a Genie Wijnaldum replacement who has played at centre-back as well, I think, for us. In three at the back. I think one game he played.
Brighton.
As a centre-back. All right. So this was the centre-back situation that we discussed. Thank you so much, everyone, for watching. We'll see you again. Take care.
Bye-bye.